In this video, we will learn how to react to user input in Unity Visual Scripting. We will explore the notes Unity offers for working with keyboard and mouse input, and manage it through the Input Manager. To react to a keyboard key press, we use the On Keyboard Input node. Select a key and an action to respond to. All the keys are available, but let's choose the right key arrow for this example. As for the action, we can choose from Hold, Down, and Up. We select down when we only care for the exact frame the key is pressed, up when the key is released, and hold for as long as the key is pressed. We would like to move the character right as long as the right arrow is held down. Therefore, we select the hold action. We will use the translate node to move the character. We cover this node in the transform video. Check it out if you are unfamiliar with it. Insert the value 0.1 at the x-axis. And now, by holding down the right arrow, the character will move along the x-axis. By duplicating this graph section while modifying the key left arrow and value to minus 0.1, we can move the character in both directions. Let's move on to exploring mouse interactions. To learn about mouse input, we will use this game object as a button. To recognize input coming from the player's mouse, we need the game object to have a physical presence in the world by adding a collider component. Colliders come in many shapes and aren't actually visible in the game. We use them to define the object's form in the scene's physics. You can check out our physics video for more about it. For now, just remember to use a 2D collider for 2D objects and regular colliders for 3D objects. It is common to mix up those, so always double check yourself. For our button, we add a box collider 2D component. In the button script graph, we have a few nodes available for mouse input. When the player presses the mouse button over a game object with a collider, the event on mouse down is triggered. When the mouse is released, the on mouse up event will be called. If you want to react to a player pressing a specific mouse button, we can use the on mouse input node to specify which button to react to and to which action. Hold, down, and up. The onMouseOver event executes every frame as long as the mouse is over the game object's collider. The onMouseExit event is triggered at the moment the mouse is no longer over the collider. We use the onMouseDrag event for reacting to a player clicking on collider while holding down the button. And finally, the onMouseUp as a button node is called when the player presses the mouse button and releases it over the exact same collider, which is a great opportunity to press and release your mouse over the like button. Unity provides us input access predefined with an intended action at the Input Manager window. To access it, go to Edit, Project Settings, Input Manager. Virtual access are mapped to physical controls, like a mouse button or a keyboard's key. When a player activates the control, the axis receives a value between negative 1 to 1. The axis value depends on the type of the physical control. For example, a keyboard's key has a value of 1 when the key is pressed down, and a value of 0 when it isn't pressed. While for a gamepad joystick, a value of 1 means the stick is pushed all the way to one direction, and the value of negative 1 means it's all the way in the other direction. A fractioned value would mean the joystick is somewhere between those extremes. But let's not get ahead of ourselves. We will cover the gamepads in another video. Two of the predefined virtual axes we will cover are the horizontal axis and the vertical axis. One for actions relevant to the x-axis, and the other for the actions relevant to the y-axis. When we open the horizontal axis, we can see how it is defined for both the arrow keys and the alternative WASD keys. The positive button is the control that yields a positive axis value, while the negative button is the control that will produce a negative value. Jumping to the jump axis, we see it's already set with the space key as its control. There are also other properties, but we will not go into them at this point, as we will just use the predefined axes as they are. Back to our script graph, we got the onButtonInput event. With this node, we can react to an input of the axes that exist in the input manager. We will use it with a virtual axis like jump. For example, let's connect this node to the translate node with a Y value of 1. When we enter play mode, we can press the space on our keyboard and the character will jump up. Another node we can use is input get axis. With it, we can get the value of the virtual axis. For example, Let's make this character move right and left using the keyboard. We start with the update event, as we constantly want to react to the player and connect it to the translate node. We want the character to move on the x-axis, so we will use the input getAxis node. Name it according to the predefined horizontal axis and connect it to the translate node using a vector3create node. This will provide the x-axis of translate values between negative 1 to 1. Now our character can move horizontally. Let's also make this character move vertically on the y-axis. We duplicate the input getAxis node, name it according to the predefined vertical axis, and connect it to the y-input. We now have a character able to move on both the x and y-axis, powered by the arrow keys and the WASD keys. The last topic we will cover is reacting to the mouse pointer's position. GetMousePosition node provides us the current pixel screen position of the mouse. Let's use it to make this object face the mouse pointer. We got familiar with the LookAt node in the previous video. We will use it to rotate the object to face the mouse as it moves. We will also use these two camera nodes to convert the screen's pixels location of the mouse into a Unity world position. We set the graph as follows. On every frame, we pass the converted Z mouse position to the LookAt node. Pressing play, we can see how the object faces the mouse pointer. In the scene window, we can observe how the blue arrow gizmo always points to the pointer position in the game window. And that's it! Thank you for following along.